I do 24 years of Perl now. We started using Perl in 1994 with our company XXLink. We were the first company in the Netherlands building websites and hosting websites. Nowadays it's called a DevOps, a name that didn't exist at the time. We were just the first one. The competition came 6 months later, and by then we had over 100 websites already online that we were paid for, and some of those were quite nicely. For instance, we sold a virtual server for something like 2,000 guilders and several hundred guilders a month for that, plus the traffic it generated. So people just happily paid it to us because there were not many alternatives. We were a company that only the first year we made a loss, and every other year we made a profit, and heavy profits. And we, at some point, 1998, 1999, we saw competition burning money like crazy and making heavy, heavy losses, and investors throwing millions in. Like, I mean, what? Then why are they getting money for making a loss? We didn't understand that. So this was our 1998 homepage. You know, it's ugly, but it was lightning fast.
HTML 0.9.
Yes. Just a big list of our customers, and several of those links went into another list of websites that we had. So we use Perl for everything. Even our graphics artists and accounting and account managers and project managers, they used Perl for everything. And some of those scripts were made by me. I could program Perl at the time. I was a bad programmer, Liz was our genius, but I could do it. I've been teaching Perl to people. That's, I think, 60, 70 people that got Perl from me, their first lessons in Perl from me. And nowadays when I think, how do I do that in Perl? I am at the loss, I can't write anymore. I do marketing better. Perlmongers came into being in 1997, and somewhere around that we had our first meeting with Perl programmers that were not from our company but from other companies as well, sitting in, basically having a Perlmongers meeting without calling it that. And after that we have hosted dozens and dozens of Perlmonger meetings at our offices, several places of our offices. And I'm doing what I'm still doing when I'm at a meeting. I will make sure that there will be something nice to drink and to eat, and some new books on the table and the stickers and whatever. I was doing that at the time as well. In the 90s, the image of Perl was you can use Perl for everything. People used Perl for everything. Other programming languages, nah. You know, if you want to do something fast and easy, do it. Use it in Perl. It was positive. It was fast, it was robust, it wouldn't crash, it was secure. If you would not use Matt's script archive, but use the better stuff. So people not knew about that. Oh, you're using Perl? Oh, we will be your customer. Excellent. So since then, we still are in love. Even though we don't need to work anymore for our money or whatever, we still use it to promote Perl. At some point I started making a calendar just for Liz and me, like which are the events that we want to go to, and we went to 3 Perlmonger meetings a month: Amsterdam Perlmongers meeting, Flanders Perlmonger meeting, and Niederrhein Perlmonger meetings, or sometimes also the Brussels Perlmonger meetings. And I wanted to have an agenda, like, okay, what can we do in our planning? And I handed out thousands of these at some point. Try to keep that up to date. I haven't done that for a while by now, but I should do that again. The latest thing on it is from the Perl conference in Amsterdam last year. So, but 3 years in a row, we went to 19 Perl events in a year. Year, 1999. Crazy, completely crazy. So we have been doing a lot of Perl things. So we have a booth at Vosdem. We have a dev room at Vosdem. And Vosdem, for the people who don't know about Vosdem, it's the biggest open source event in the world. 12,000 people come there in 2 days. They have I'll talk about that later. Well, we've been doing OSCON, but OSCON is too expensive and everybody expects stuff to get us for free. Oh, I will take this camel. Oh, no, that's $25. What? You want to have money for that? So OSCON, no, well. A typical Pearl booth, and a typical helpful guy. We noticed in all the years since 2000 that the image became. We have a question?
No.
Okay. The attitude became more negative. Like Liz pointed out that we have some stuff there. And it became so bad. I've seen so many flame wars that people called me an idiot and a loser, and several people even called me a fascist. Okay, I will get out of step back from Pearl at some point. I looked a bit more from the sideline, and it took me a couple of years to pick that up again, of all the negativity. And I was quite happy that at some point the flame wars ended and people agreed to not do that anymore. Pearl is dead, Pearl is line noise, and corpse shit done and that type of stuff about Pearl, which made me sad. So I wanted to do something about that, and Liz as well. Fosdem, it happened 3 years in a row that we had a booth there, and this little Belgian guy came to us, and as soon as he saw us from afar, he started screaming, "You should die! You should die! Why are you here? You're a disgrace for the programming world." Stuff like that. We was standing there smiling. Yeah, okay. Well, we love you too. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. made him even more mad. So at some point, a couple of years later, he stopped doing that, but still. So I was sad. At some point, we had the little business cards. We suck at marketing, but we have. And on the other side, that would be something wonderful that we have, like CPAN or Moose or something. I still have a small collection of those business cards. But at some point, I started making stuff for the Pearl community. So I started making buttons and stickers and tuits, and I had brochures and had pens made. The pens were like, poof, gone. A little bit too expensive to keep on making them. But that didn't change the image that much. How we have been thinking with a lot of people how to change the image of Pearl from your shit and a corpse and dung from nice. Just by keep going on and keep being positive and keep developing the stuff. And well, lots of people did that, and Liz and I supported a lot of people doing that. There's a couple of people here who know that personally, that we helped them. At some point, that was my table. And we can see my table is twice as large now. And just how many programming languages do you know that have all that type of stuff? Like at Fosdem, a programming language is a train station?
Well,
yes, you're right. Yeah, you're right. So, what happened at Fosdem was that Python people would come to the Pearl booth and say the stuff like, "Why are you doing here? And what right do you have to be here? Because Pearl is it's almost down the drain." And I asked them, "Well, show me the Python booth at this conference." "Well, we don't have any." "Well, can I go to a Python talk at a Python dev room?" "No, we don't have a dev room." "Do you have Python Mongo meetings or something monthly in your city?" "No, we don't have that." "And you're saying that Pearl is dead? Really? It sounds like Python is nowhere." So at some point, Python did have a dev room and a booth. And the organizers, in all their wisdom, put the Python booth next to the Pearl booth. And we had two big tables next to each other, completely and utterly filled. Every square centimeter was filled with stuff, different stuff. And the Python booth was one table, and they had one pile of books, a small pile of t-shirts, and a small pile of stickers. This was all that they had on the table. And we had a lot of visitors, and they were sitting there behind their desk with three laptops and, oh, hello, yeah, what? Yeah, yeah, that's free, take it. And then kept on hacking. While at the Perl booth, we were energetic, walking around, people, inviting people over. It was, most of the time, was busy at the Perl booth. And I overheard one of the Python people saying to one of the organizers, why do the Perl people have two tables while we have only one? And the organizer said, but you have only three things on your table. Look at what they have. Yeah, but they are Perl and we are Python. We are better. So we should have two tables and they only one. Really, the guy from the organization, the Vosden, was baffled, like, I'm not going to react to this. So, code Perl, yeah, calm. Nowadays, for the last couple of years, we've been trying to tell people about this. To improve Perl, to improve the image of Perl, we need more stuff like this. More books, new books, and newer versions of old books. Like, I really, really would like to have a new version of Perl Best Practices. Yeah? That's one of the books I really would like. Perl Testing, I would like to have a new version of that. And, by the way, of both books, a Perl 6 version as well. Really, would like to have that. So, I would like to have educational materials for trainers, training institutes, universities, schools. I've been asked several times by somebody, Wendy, would you like to cooperate with me to write a Perl 6 book for young girls? And boys would be happy with it as well, but aimed at young girls. Well, I would like to see such a book, but I'm not going to write it, because my Perl skills are very much in the small size. I would like to have to see more articles about Perl written in magazines. I've seen so many blogs out there, yeah, but it's in crowd. Only Perl people visit that. But it's not in Linux magazine, it's not in Der Zeit or Die Welt or the Washington Post. Articles about Perl. Yeah, you see sometimes articles about Haskell or Go or whatever in stuff like that, but not about Perl. So we need to do that more. We have to go out more. Jens has tried to get a journalist here. He failed. We tried to do the same for the Perl conference in Amsterdam. We failed. We do get occasional journalists at the booth at Vosden.
This is just because we do not have articles. When we would have more articles,
yes,
in the magazines, the journalists would come.
Yes.
So probably the
best
idea is when we all try to write articles.
Yes. So if we are more visible to the outside world, we make ourselves more interesting to visit for other people. There's a supermarket chain in the Netherlands. They use Perl for their cash registers. Yeah, there's Linux computers with Perl things on it. When you scan a product, it does beep beep. That's a Perl program doing that. Management of the supermarket barely knows that it's Perl. They expect it to be another programming language. When I asked those people of that department, would you like to talk about this at a Perl conference? No, don't do that. Well, when we're going to speak at a conference, upper management knows about it and they will tell us, shut down the whole shit and rewrite it in Java or Python or whatever. And man, it will be slow and difficult and whatever. And this, doing it in Perl, that's fun. So, and we have to go to more conferences like Vosdem and Tidos and whatever. You're going to FrostCon, I guess, again. So
yeah.
René Becker will be at FrostCon again. That's also such a very nice conference where a lot of Perl haters visited the booth. I've been there once. Well, the one time that we had the main room of Vosdem filled, Larry Wall announced Perl 6 there, packed. And he got a standing ovation when he said, this year is the year that Perl 6 will be released. So that was nice, seeing all those non-Perl people saying wow about Perl.
Too bad Vosdem screwed up and actually
lost
the video.
The video was not stored. And it was, It was streamed on the internet and nobody saved a copy. Really, Vosdam is big. It's really, really big. It's hard to imagine how big it is. Pearl Dev rooms, most of the time they're packed. We have to put a sign on the outside, it's full, don't come in. People are even angry about coming to the booth. The Pearl Dev room is full the whole time, I can't get in. Okay. OSCON. This made it, okay, I'm almost done, I think. This made it to an action of O'Reilly for coming to OSCON, inviting people to OSCON. So that was nice. That was the first one of their action this year. Like, Wendy, have you seen this?
Picture of a pinned tweet of O'Reilly.
Yes. So we improved the image of Pearl. All of us did that, and I love you all for that. Thank you. Stopping flame wars. If somebody is going to be angry about something, be nice. Don't be angry back. Don't tell them they're all idiots. I have hardly seen any obfuscated code contest in the last couple of years. Every now and then I see it and I think, well, maybe you should document that stuff. No, that's not the point. Well, I'm very happy with Modern Pearl, even though I'm not happy with the butterfly on the book, but still. But the idea of Modern Pearl is very nice. We still have quite a lot of conferences, workshops, hackathons. We still have a nice amount of books, even though my table of books, I only sold one Pearl 5 book, and that was the Pearl Pocket reference, and all the other books I sold are Pearl 6 books. So thank you for that. But still, it's nice that when you go to a conference and you see Pearl people, they have a friendly face and they're inviting and they will tell you about Pearl. And that we are welcoming to newbies. So like 2 days ago, some of you showed your hand. That was your first conference. I think I've said welcome to 3 or 4 newbies that told me that there was the first time. I said, welcome to Pearl. So that makes a difference. So my opinion is we are on the up again. Like, and I know that there's more jobs and more newbies and more projects. Maybe not in Germany, maybe not in the UK, but if you go to Romania, there are quarterly Perlmonger meetings. They have something like 150 people in the room, and the average age is below 30, and more than half of the people in the room are young women. When I was there, I was like, wow, that's cool. I want to have that in the Netherlands. So if you help Pearl, you will help yourself. Because if you want to keep on programming Pearl, you have to help Pearl as well. So you have to write, blog, present, do presentations. You organize things, you have to discuss it, you have to chat, you have to patch, you have to donate, you have to go to an expo, you organize an expo, whatever. Do that. Because that way you're helping Pearl, and other people will see Pearl, your boss might see Pearl, your client might see Pearl and think, oh, that's positive. Let's continue doing stuff with Pearl. If you don't do it, nobody does it. Well, maybe I, but... if you write an article or whatever about Pearl, don't just use the word Pearl in your article. Use the three words Pearl programming language at least once. Maybe you have heard about Tyobi, yes? They look at Pearl programming language. If they see the word Pearl and they don't see programming language, it doesn't count with Tyobi. So we will be low on the list. I would write the English word because that's what Tyobi looks at. Yeah, at least one time use Pearl programming language.
I think at least Lanx and I have it in our signatures on Perlmonks. So
yes.
Every time we comment anything.
Yeah. But anywhere else, if you do it on a WordPress or whatever, write Pearl programming language. Mitaldo wrote an interesting article about it. It's getting a bit old, but it's still to the point. So what happened? I noticed that people don't come to our booth anymore and said, Pearl? I thought Pearl was dead. They don't do that anymore. People even come to us and say nice things to us. Like, I love Pearl. I'm happy you're here. I am using Perl again. I was with that other programming language, but I'm using Perl again for new stuff. Makes me happy. So thank you for doing that. Happy Wendy. And that was it.